Hello everyone, welcome to Magical Fluency. Today we'll be talking about a reveal between two major proofreaders, Grammarly VS ProWritingAid in 2021. Many YouTube creators have already done such comparisons. As you can see, if you do a search on YouTube, Grammarly VS ProWritingAid, there are many videos already, and one of them is made by me in 2020. So today we'll be dealing with 2021. So they don't actually know what exactly the mistakes the proofreaders can't catch, and they may not put the proofreaders in a fair test to compare their accuracy. Many people know about Grammarly in the advertisements. As you can see, if you just do a simple search on Grammarly advertisements, many people already know what are they. But seldom will they see advertisements related to ProWritingAid. In fact, if we go to ProWritingAid website, ProWritingAid mentioned that it is cheaper because it doesn't have to spend all the money on advertising. But is Grammarly or ProWritingAid better in terms of catching grammar and spelling mistakes? In today's test, we'll find out. As you can see, there are 50 sentences, and each sentence actually contains one mistake. And we'll calculate the final score by seeing how many mistakes they can catch and whether they can suggest the correct one. So what I'm going to do is to copy all of the words from this document into Grammarly's and ProWritingAid's online editors. As you can see, I've already done so. As you can see, there is something called the false positive test. It is to have a look at whether they will give incorrect suggestions on these three sentences which are originally correct. That sentence is originally correct, and see if it wrongly flags something that is wrong. The test will be very accurate given the amount of mistakes we put into the test. So, should we start now? I'm gonna put it in a fast forward mode so that you don't have to wait for half an hour or whatever it takes to complete the test. Let's get started. Woohoo, the test is finally complete, and we do not know what is the number of misses they have, so I'm gonna calculate it now. Calculated, and as you can see, the accuracy isn't very nice, and yeah, the accuracy isn't very good. It's just around 36% for the accuracy of, and for Grammarly and for ProWritingAid, the accuracy is just 32%. Now, one of the questions I think that ProWritingAid really is nice and have improved is about this. It actually determines that English is a subject, and this is just a clause. So that means that this should be referring to English, and English is a singular noun. So that would be the case for Grammarly VS ProWritingAid. In this 2021, we find out that Grammarly is still outperforming ProWritingAid.